In the House of Commons, Boris faces questions on how P&O Cruises was allowed to sack 800 members of staff via Zoom.
Mr. Speaker, 800 loyal British workers fired over Zoom. Instantly replaced by foreign agency workers shipped in on less than £2 an hour. If the Prime Minister can't stop that, then what's the point of his government?
Mr. Speaker, P&O. P&O. Of course, Mr. Speaker, we don't deny that the actions of the company are callous and cruel towards these hard-working mariners. But what does P&O stand for, if not personal opportunity, Mr. Speaker? Instead of whinging about 800 people being made unemployed, perhaps the right smelly gentleman should consider that we've now got 800 people to work on the farms, Mr. Speaker. 800 people to pick fruit, Mr. Speaker. 800 people to drive lorries, Mr. Speaker. Those are jobs that are available, by the way, thanks to Brexit, which we delivered and which he would have cancelled, Mr. Speaker. Then how would these poor ex-mariners stay afloat, if you'll pardon the pun?
Mr. Speaker, the day before P&O sacked 800 British workers via Zoom, they sent a memo to the Prime Minister informing him of their intentions. He did nothing to stop it. Did he not read the memo? Or could he just not be asked to do anything?
I am far too busy delivering on the priorities of this country, sanctioning Russia, reducing the national debt, getting Brexit done, to bother reading every memo that pops into my WhatsApp inbox.
Is the Prime Minister saying he receives official briefings through WhatsApp? Isn't that a major security concern?
Later that day, Chancellor Rishi Sunak announced his spring budget to the House.
I know that times are hard. The cost of living is soaring, and it's something that I have seen every day, even in my own chateau, where my servants talk of little else. Honestly, it's a little annoying. Please, Mr. Sunak, can we have some more bread, seriously? Hell, even I'm feeling the pinch. Last week, I could only afford 7 varieties of cream cheese on my post-dinner crackers. But rest assured, Dishy Wishy is here to save the day again. That's right, from the man who brought you furlough and Eat Out to Help Out, say hello to my brand new money-saving scheme, Heating or Eating. From Monday, anyone earning less than £60,000 a year will now be able to choose between eating and heating their homes, and we'll be providing a £3 Boots voucher to help them make that choice. I'm also cutting taxes for banks, building societies and large businesses by 75%. I am, after all, a low-tax chancellor, providing it's the right kind of tax and you're the right kind of person. To those silly-billy lefty idiots who wanted me to cancel my discriminatory national insurance hike, I say poo-poo. It's going ahead. Why? Because I'm the chancellor and you're not. I'm also going to raise the threshold that the national insurance is paid at, and act like I'm doing the poor a favour, even though it will lock thousands out of sick pay and reduce millions of people's pensions in years to come. Finally, I will be taking 5p per pound off the fuel duty, so you can fill up your tank safe in the knowledge that it only cost as much as it did 3 days ago, and the reduction will be completely undone by this time tomorrow. Yay for me. I know that it's tempting to issue handout after handout after handout. But think about it. If the poor starve, there's more fuel to go round. Everybody wins. Dishy Wishy out.
The next day, Liz Truss is celebrating having secured the release of Nazanin Zaghari Ratcliffe, who had been held in Iran for 6 years. So for the tweet, man, we were thinking, I am delighted that Nazanin, Anoushesh and Morad have been released by the Iranians and will be reunited with their family and loved ones. With a nice picture of the Ratcliffe family together.
Is that next to my picture?
Actually, Bob, we thought it'd be better to focus on the family for this one.
Of course, that's great. So we're taking a photo with me and the family?
No, Mom, not you. Just the Ratcliffes.
Super. But what about me?
Mom, this really isn't about you.
Sorry, you've lost me.
This is about the Ratcliffes and Nazanin's freedom?
Sorry, let's start again. When's the photo shoot?
Never. There is no photo shoot. This is a statement by you, but it's not for you. We're not trying to big you up. Not this time.
Fuck me. It's like your death. Photo of me when take we are the.
Oh, for fuck's sake. It's the Tory Spring Conference, and Boris is giving a speech to a crowd of adoring sycophants.
And I think we can all appreciate the pain that they're going through. Struggling through fierce oppression and a constant deluge of hatred and lies. Violence the likes of which we have not seen since David shot his mighty sling into the forehead of the mighty Goliath. But, my friends, Romans and countrymen, they will not be defeated. They will not be dissuaded, and they will not be undone. I speak, of course, of the brave Brexiteers standing fast in the face of left wokey-wokey Ramonas. And in a way, isn't the struggle of the brave Brexiteer much like the struggle of our Ukrainian friends? I was talking to my good friend Zelensky the other day, and he said, Boza! He called me Boza, because we're such besties. He said, Boza, how do you manage to be so goddamn handsome and also the best leader the world has ever seen? True story, true story. I know a lot of the woke mafia like to draw comparisons between myself and President Trump. I'm sure we're both overweight, self-absorbed pricks with ridiculous hair. But deep down, I like to think I'm more of a Churchill, in that I'm fat, always pissed, and need a war to stay in power. So what I'm really saying is cheers, Putin. You've really taken the heat off the whole Partygate thing. I think that's something we could all do to think about.
Oh, dear Lord. You made many, many poor people. I realize, of course, it's no shame to be poor. But it's no great honor either. So what would have been so terrible if I had a small fortune?
If you were a rich man, yabba dibba dibba dabba dabba dibba dibba dit. Maybe then I'd give a little shit. If you were a wealthy man, you wouldn't have to work hard. Yabba dibba 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 dabba dibba dibba dat. I'd make sure you never pay a penny's tax, you idle diddle idle idle man. You'd have a massive mansion. No, you'd have a dozen in Islington and Moscow and in Spain. And you would have a rich man's brain. From the moment you were born, you would have been on the up, and nothing you could say would bring you down. You'd learn that empathy is just a show. 'Cause all the plebs are turkeys voting for Christmas. See how they faint and fawn and cheer. Give them a peanut and they'll be your fan. And each loud Rishi, yay!
You're my hero, Rishi!
Would land like a trumpet on the ear. The most important men in town would be your bevy mate. They would pay you to advise you, and for you to close your eyes. You're so dishy, it's so wishy. And we wish we were you, wishy. Better than the other Tory guys. Eat out to help out, eating will go out. And it won't make one bit of difference if
I answer right or wrong, right or wrong. Cause you're not rich, so you don't get a say. Oh, if you were a witch man, yabba dibba 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 dong,
la 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 la,
you would get a chance to sing your song. If you were a wealthy man, you wouldn't starve to death now. Yabba dibba 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 dick. Lord who made the lorry and the car, you decreed things should be what they are. Things are smashing, I'm such a fucking star. Rishi, you will go far.
Well, that was both uncomfortable and scarily believable. Over in Europe, Boris attends an urgent NATO meeting on the situation in Ukraine. However, his comments comparing Ukraine's desperate situation to Brexit have not earned him any favours. I literally didn't have to write a sketch here. The comedy speaks for itself. Let's enjoy several clips of our Prime Minister being ignored completely like he's the icky nose-picking kid in the class with no friends. I may have enhanced them slightly. Ladies and gentlemen, Boris Johnson.
You want to come over here and have a no, no, of course not. No.
Hey, Boris, is it? You know, you're a massive asshole. Everybody thinks it, a massive piece of shit.
Yes, so people keep telling me.
He really is a piece of shit.
Oh, that's nice. Twat. I hate these things. Macron, if you're not going to talk to me, could you back off? Back off, you French prick.
Well, that's all we've got time for this week. If you like more political comedy, tune into any news programme where a member of the cabinet is speaking. They're all a fucking joke. Bye!